Check. So I just have about 3 hours to compose a music for a television commercial. So there's hardly any time to be creative, and as a result, my music started sounding very robotic. It sounded like any other commercial you see on television. It was okay in the beginning because it was paying the bills and the clients were getting satisfied, but I didn't want to limit myself in just producing music for other people just for the sake of promoting an advertisement. I wanted to compose my own music, I wanted to express my own feelings, and I wanted to communicate it to people by traveling around the world. But I was lost, I didn't really know how I was going to do it. So one day back in 2010, my brother randomly sent me a video of a guitar player named McKee. He was playing one of his tunes called Drifting. That video was a renaissance moment for me. The gentleman in the video was playing the guitar in a very, very unusual way. He was playing the bass, the rhythm, the percussion, the drums, and the melody, all these different elements at the same time with just one acoustic guitar without using any special effects. So it was all happening organically. The moment I saw that video, I was immediately picturing myself playing the guitar that way and playing my music, my own composed music. So the first thing which I did was I downloaded the entire video and I slowed it down to 50%. And I started mirroring his techniques. I started watching his hands closely, and it was really frustrating in the beginning because I was not getting anything, but I kept on practicing, and after hours and hours of practice, I was finally able to get the techniques down. So I'm going to demonstrate what exactly was happening. So if you're not familiar with this style of playing before, and if you have seen guitar players playing the guitar, you usually play like below the neck. This part is called as neck or the fretboard. You play it like this. He was just using his middle, this first index finger, to play a rhythmic bass line. It goes something like this. And it's just an example. And I'm just using my first finger. It's a Deep Purple song. Now this wood over here, the body, is actually a drum kit. I mean, you can use your heel to create a drum kick sound, and that's a snare. Combine both of them together. Something like that. Now, I still have these four strings to play the melody. And this was just a bass line and a drum kit. So I'm going to play a snippet of the tune which I learned. It's called Drifting. And it goes something like this. Shows and festivals nationally and internationally as well. Last year I was invited to play in Mexico to play at the Zivataneho International Guitar Festival. And as of now, I'm signed to a record label called Red Monkey Records, which is based in the US, who most recently invited me at the NAMM show in Los Angeles, California. I still have a very long way to go, but I'm a discoverer and a keen explorer of music. I'm going to end my set with another performance. It's the first tune which I wrote on the acoustic guitar. The tune which actually kick-started my solo acoustic guitar career and makes me feel honored to have this stage in front of you. Thank you. A little trivia on the tune which I'm about to play. First of all, it is on an alternate tuning. I mean, my guitar is tuned in a different way. That's the reason why I switched to guitar, just in case you're wondering. Another thing, when I was composing this tune, I had no idea what I was doing with the guitar because I was just randomly experimenting with different techniques. And I ended up constructing a song. It was more like a jam, which ended up in a song. So I was really terrified to upload it on YouTube because it has so many techniques, and you can see my hand is flying in the air most of the time while I'm playing the song. So I was really terrified to upload it on YouTube because it's really tough to play, and it's literally like the toughest song I know to play on the guitar. And later, when people started calling me for shows and all that, I was really terrified to play it in front of people. But you know, at the end of the day, it's really not art if it doesn't have potential to be a complete disaster. So just go with it. So here's Dear Mother for you all, and I hope you all enjoy it. Thank you.